curvy part is, and now I will explain the topic wheel life cycle. Now, the wheel life, as we know that spring controls many methods, well, wheel makes a vital role in doing the control in the spring container. So let's see one by one steps. Now, this is instant shape. What is instant shape? Whenever we create an object, we make the word keyword new. To instantiate the object. And whenever we want to populate the properties in it, we make use of populate property. And whenever we want to get the name of the wheel, that is name of the object we want to aware, to get the name of the object, we use wheel name aware as an implementation, means a class implement wheel name aware, and then it will fit implement the method as set wheel name. So it will give the exact name in which what is the name of that wheel. And then next will be the wheel factory aware. If the class implement wheel factory aware, then it will override the method set wheel factory, and it will get the in which wheel factory it is existing. So then it will application context aware is implemented by any class, then it will override the set application context method, and it will give in which application it is existing, and it will give the name of that. And then it comes to pre-initialization. As we know that there is the method of initialization. So whenever we are doing any kind of initialization, means any kind of working, at that time there is a pre and a post. So during the pre-initialization method, if we are implementing the pre-initialization, then we will get the override method as being post process. And what is being post process? There are two types of being post process, which are post process before initialization and post process after initialization. And when before is there, at that time this method will be implemented here, override written here. And whenever it is after, then it is post process after initialization. Means what? Here, initialization being is implemented at that time after properties are set. Means what? The middle portion, this one. When we are getting the properties, at that time initialization being is used. Means what? We get the properties of that. And then what? This was call custom init method. Call custom init method is XML method. We use it during the XML. We use in the B tag, we use init method. Whenever we want to retrieve it, we make use of init method. Okay, and this is post initialization. Here also being post process is used. Means here, as I already said that in being post process, there is both of them. So in the post initialization, we make use of post process after initialization. And then after all these processes, the bean is ready to use. We can make use of that object or that. And then it is container. Then the container gets shut down. Means, and during shutdown, we make use of close method. This is very compulsory to shut down. And disposal field is implemented, then we will override the method destroy. Means that the complete pin will get destroyed. And then after destroying the pin, the custom call destroy method is used. This is also an XML, and we can make use of destroy method in the